A blessed and joyful Monday to all of you. Hope you had a great weekend. Oh man, here in St. Louis, where we are in Missouri, it was just so beautiful. Man, mid-high 70s, sunny. I was praising the Lord all weekend long. Thank you, God. Thank you. But thank you, too, for joining us here in prayer at the God Minute as we begin our new week together. I'm Father Ron Hoy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 65, The Earth's Joy. It is good to give thanks to our God for the boundless mercy which renews us and makes us whole.
You make the sunrise and the sunset shout for joy. You are the earth's fertility. Your law governs her cycles of snow, flood, and rain. You crown the year with abundance. The wild lands are watered with dew.
The meadows adorn themselves with flocks. The valleys gown themselves with grain. They dance together. They join in song.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. A young man approached Jesus and said, "Teacher, what good must I do to gain eternal life?" He answered him, "Why do you ask me about the good? There's only one who is good. If you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments." He asked him, "Which ones?" And Jesus replied, "You shall not kill, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, honor your father and your mother, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself." The young man said to him, "All of these I have observed. What do I still lack?" Jesus said to him, "If you wish to be perfect, go, sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." When the young man heard this statement, he went away sad, for he had many possessions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I don't know about you, but when I hear this passage, a great deal runs through my mind. First of all, I have to wonder if the young man is being sincere or if he's actually looking to just find out what's the bare minimum I need to get into the kingdom. I mean, let's face it, when you're young, you want to put the least amount of effort towards being good. Not to mention the fact that if you have to do good works, volunteer for something or do something for others, that means whatever it is going to interfere with your free time / fun time. So Jesus responds to him by stating the obvious. If you want life, keep the commandments. Okay, which ones specifically? Well, it appears that he highlights all the ones that have to do with others, namely the love your neighbor as yourself commandments. You know, the last seven. The young man's response seems to indicate, "Excellent, I'm doing all these." Then the other shoe drops. If I'm doing all this, why am I still not happy? What am I lacking? Here's where Jesus challenges the young man and me and you today. Give everything you have away. Wow, seriously? Everything? Over the 33 years that I've been a priest and the 60 years that I've been alive, I've been blessed to receive a lot of things. My first assignment, I think I was able to move everything from the seminary to the rectory with a pickup truck and my car. over the years, that rapidly progressed to needing to hire movers to get me settled. Over the course of my life, I've discovered that the things that I have are far less important than my relationship with God. You see, that relationship has given me the freedom to not allow things to possess me. I think that's the whole point of this passage, by the way. Eventually, we have to stop thinking about what's the bare minimum that I need to get by and start thinking, how in love am I with the Lord? How much of myself am I willing to give away in order to receive all that the Lord wants to give to me? You see, I think true happiness comes from a willingness to do God's will and loving Him enough to care for those around me. I may not be perfect yet, and Lord knows I'm trying to work at it. But I believe that the more I follow Jesus, the more contagious His example becomes in my life.
And with your brothers and sisters all over the world praying with you, we together lift our voice and pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, I feel anxiety in my life because of the many decisions. How I need wisdom to discern the best path, the best choice. Educate my heart and mind to make me wiser and a better steward of the resources you have given me. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in His kindness, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you for being with us in prayer today. Couple of things before we leave. We send out a weekly email to all our subscribers. It's called The Week Ahead, and it comes out on Sunday or Monday morning, just to give you an overview of, well, the week ahead and our prayer and reflections with some other fun things. But we've heard back that some of you have not received those. So if you haven't gotten them, it's probably in your junk folder. So if you just go in there and unjunk it, it'll continue then in the future weeks. You won't have to worry about it. So the email is called The Week Ahead, if you want to do a search for it. And it's from prayer@thegodminute.org. So you can find it that way as well. So just unjunk it, and then from now on, you're good. So also, if you have any prayers or intentions that you would like me and my brother priest to lift up in prayer with you every morning at Mass, just send them to us at that same email, prayer@thegodminute.org, and we place those at our altar where we have Mass every morning. So let our voices join yours in whatever it is you're lifting to the heavens. God bless you all. Thank you for starting your week with us. We'll see you tomorrow.